Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on calculation of moment of inertia for a T section. Here is the question. It is given that a T section has the following dimensions: flange 200 mm into 20 mm, web 20 mm into 200 mm, overall depth is 220 mm. We have to find Ixx and Iyy. It means here in this data, first I'll mention that it is a T-section in which the flange is having the dimension as 200 into 20. So I'll write down flange is equal to 200 mm into 20 mm. Next, web is 20 mm into 200 mm. And the overall depth is 220. 220 mm. Find Ixx and Iyy. So here the question is, we have to calculate Ixx, that is moment of inertia about xx axis, and Iyy, that is moment of inertia about yy axis. So this is the question we have in front of us. Now with the data available, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution part, first I'll draw the T section, and for that I'll draw an axis system. Here we have x and y axis. So here is the T section, and as it is mentioned, now flange is having the dimension of 200 into 20. So this topmost portion, it is the flange, and it has a width of 20 mm. Width is 200. So here the width of the flange is 200 mm. Then its height is 20 mm, or you can say the depth is 20. Next, web, it is 20 mm into 200 mm. So the width of the web, which is the central portion, is 20 mm by 200 mm. And it is given that the overall depth is 220 mm. So if we add 220, the overall depth becomes 220 mm. So this diagram is correct. Now we have to find out the moment of inertia about x-axis and y-axis for the given T section. And for that purpose, first we should know where is the centroid located for this T section. Now if I see this, this T section is symmetric about the vertical axis, or I can say the y-axis. T section is symmetric about this y-axis. So the distance of this y-axis from the y-axis of the system, this distance would be called as x bar, and I'll write it in this way, that since the given T section is symmetric about y-axis, so therefore I'll write down x bar will be, it will be exactly half of 200, that is the total width, so it comes out to be 100 mm. X bar is 100 mm. Now once we know x bar, we can say that centroid is located on this y-axis, but at which height, that we do not know, and for that we require y bar. So here I'll write down, now since the location of centroid with respect to x-axis is given by, the location with respect to x-axis is called as y bar, and that will be a1 into y1 plus a2 into y2 upon area 1 plus area 2. I'll highlight this and keep it as equation number 1. Now I'll divide this figure, that is the T section, into two rectangles. This one will become the first rectangle for us, and here we have the second rectangle. So now I'll calculate the area of the respective rectangles. So therefore I'll say area 1 will be equal to the first rectangle. It has width 20 and height is 200, so it is 20 into 200. That gives me the answer as 4 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. Then y1 is the x-axis for the first rectangle. Its height is 200, so x-axis will lie at half of 200, so y1 will be 200 divided by 2, that is equal to 100 mm. Then area 2, it will be equal to 200 into 20. Again, this also comes out to be 4 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. And y2 value will be, y2 is the x-axis for the second rectangle, and it will be located at 200 plus half of 20, because the section 2, the rectangle 2, is at a distance of 200 mm from the x-axis. So it is 200 plus half of 20. That is the location of x-axis for the second rectangle. And this value, it comes out to be 210 mm. Now after this, I'll say that therefore put all values in equation number 1. And after putting all values, we get y bar as, it was area 1. Area 1 is 4 into 10 raised to 3 into y1, that is 100, plus area 2, 4 into 10 raised to 3 into y2, that is 210 upon area 1 plus area 2. So here I will get the answer of y bar. It comes out to be 155 mm. And as we have taken all the references from bottom x-axis, so this 155 mm, it is from bottom. Similarly, I can get y bar from top as well. So that will be from the total height, that is 220, I will subtract 155. So 220 minus 155, that gives me 65 mm from top. So now I can locate the y-axis, and it is at a distance of 155 mm from bottom. This is the x-axis, and its location is given by y-bar is equal to 155 mm from bottom, and from the top it is 65 mm. So here I have located the x-axis, y-axis was located, and here we have the centroid of the given T section. So now, once we have located the centroid, now we can easily calculate the moment of inertia. First about x-axis, then about y-axis. I'll say that, therefore, MI, that is moment of inertia, about horizontal xx axis is given by ixx is equal to ixx1 plus ixx2, keeping this as equation number 2nd. Now, as we have two different areas, so the total moment of inertia about xx axis will be ixx1, that is the MI of first section about the x-axis, then MI of the second section about the x-axis. So now, I'll say that after this, therefore, IXX1 will be given by IG1, or I can say it is IG1 plus area 1 into H1 square. And why I'm using this, it is called as by parallel axis theorem. So therefore, IXX1 will be equal to IG1. Now IG1 is, as we can see from the diagram, the x-axis for the complete T-section is at 155 mm from bottom, but the x-axis for rectangle number 1, rectangle 1 is having a height of 200, so its x-axis will be passing through exactly half of its height, that is 100 mm we can say, from bottom. So now it means here there is the difference between the x-axis of the T-section and of rectangle number 1, and this distance is nothing but h1, so it will be 155 minus 100. So here I'll say first ig1 is the moment of inertia formula about x-axis, which is bd cube by 12 plus area 1 is b into d, and h1 will be 155 minus 100 whole square. So therefore IXX1 will be equal to, now B and D values for the rectangle number 1, B is 20, D is 200, so 20 into 200 cube divided by 12 plus B into D, the area was 4 into 10 raised to 3, and this will be 55 whole square. Now after the calculation of this complete term, I'll get my answer of IXX1, which is 25.43 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. So this is IXX1, the moment of inertia for the first rectangle about the XX axis of the T section. Now in the same manner, I'll calculate IXX2, and that is IG2 plus area 2 into H2 square. I'll say that this is by parallel axis theorem. So therefore IXX2 will be, now IG2 is again, since we are calculating about x-axis, so MI about x-axis, that is BD cube by 12 plus area is B into D. Now H2, if we see in this diagram, the x-axis of complete T-section is located at 65 mm from top, but the x-axis of rectangle number 2, it is located at a distance of, we can say, half of 20, that is 10 mm from top. So here there is some difference between these two axes, and this distance is nothing but h2. So here while writing h2, I'll say that it will be 65 minus this distance, which is nothing but half of 20, that is 10 mm. So from 65, if we subtract 10, we are going to get h2. So 65 minus, I'll write down half of 20, which is 10 whole square. So therefore IXX2 will be equal to, now B and D values for the rectangle second, B is 200, D is 20. So 200 into 20 cube divided by 12 plus area is 4 into 10 raised to 3. This will be 65 minus 10 whole square. So on calculating the entire term here, my answer of IXX2, that comes out to be, it is 12.23 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. After getting IXX1 and IXX2, I'll say that putting those values in equation number second, so I'll put the values here. So therefore put IXX1 and IXX2 in equation number second. So here we have IXX is equal to, now IXX1 was 25.43 into 10 raised to 6 plus IXX2, 12.23 into 10 raised to 6. So therefore IXX value, it comes out to be 37.66 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. So this is the first answer. Now the second part, here we have to even calculate IYY, so I'll write down, therefore MI about vertical centroidal axis, that is y axis, is given by Iyy will be equal to Iyy1 plus Iyy2. So therefore Iyy will be equal to, now if we see the moment of inertia about the vertical axis, for that case, now it is very interesting here that the y axis of complete T section passes at 100 mm from, we can say, the y axis, which is the reference here. Next, the y axis for rectangle number 1 will also be passing through this 100 mm distance. Similarly, for rectangle 2 also, it will be at 100 mm distance. It means all the y axis, they are passing through the same line. So there is no parallel distance between the two axes, and it can be solved without parallel axis theorem. So directly I can apply the formula. Iyy is dB cube by 12 for the first rectangle. Iyy2 is dB cube by 12 for the second rectangle. So therefore Iyy will be equal to, now D and B values. For the first rectangle, D is 200, B is 20. So 200 into 20 cube divided by 12. Plus, for the second rectangle, we have D as 20, B as 200. On calculation, I'll get my answer of Iyy as 13.47 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. So here is the second answer. So as we see the question, there were two things asked, Ixx and Iyy. Ixx value we have calculated, it was 37.66 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. So this first question is solved. Next, for Iyy, we have got the answer as 13.47 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4 Iyy. And while finding both the answers, we can say that the problem has been completed.